Hello friends, here in this video we are going to see a problem on calculation of Poisson's ratio. So here we have this question. Now whatever is given in this question, I'll read it and write that in the form of data first. Let us get started. Now it is given that modulus of rigidity of a material is 0.8 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square. Modulus of rigidity is denoted by capital G. Next, when a 6 into 6 mm square rod, the area of the rod is given. As it is seen, here this is the width and here we have thickness. So the cross section area of the rod is a square. So here B is equal to 6 mm and even T is equal to 6 mm width and thickness. Now area will be 6 into 6, that comes out to be 36 mm square. Was subjected to an axial pull of 3600 Newton. This is the axial pull, or we can say axial force. So P is 3600 Newton. It was found that the lateral dimension changed to, now when the load was applied, this width of 6 mm gets reduced, it becomes 5.9991, and even the thickness is reduced, it becomes 5.991 mm square. So this is the new area which we are getting. So I'll write down, therefore new area is equal to 5.991 into 5.991 mm square. From this area I can see that this is the change in width, so it will be delta B is equal to 5.991 mm, and similarly delta T, the thickness, it will be 5.991 mm. Next, find Poisson's ratio and modulus of elasticity. So in this question, I have to calculate how much is the value of mu, that is Poisson's ratio, and how much is the modulus of elasticity. So with these much data available, let us try to get the solution to this problem. In the solution part, as in this problem load and area are given, first I'll get the value of stress, and before that I can even explain it with the help of a diagram in a more better manner. So here is this square bar which is subjected to axial pull denoted by capital P. Now this axial pull, it will be parallel to this length. Now because of the action of this axial pull, the square cross section length of this square bar will increase, whereas the width and thickness will go on decreasing. So if I want to draw this, it will be something like this. So here is the diagram, that the length will increase and the other two dimensions, that is width and thickness, will go on decreasing under the action of pull type of force. So now first I'll write down, since stress induced in the square bar sigma is equal to P upon A, so therefore sigma is equal to P is given in the problem, it is 3600 Newton. Area, it is the original area, that is before deformation, 36 mm square. So 36. From this, I'll get the value of stress as 100 Newton per mm square. Now, after getting stress, the first question is, we want the value of mu. So, in order to calculate mu, which is called as Poisson's ratio, and it is given by lateral strain upon linear strain. So, to calculate mu, first we should have the lateral strain. And how to get that? As we have delta B and delta T, we can select any one of them and find the lateral strain. So here I'll say that after this, since lateral strain is given by, suppose we are taking the width, so change in width upon original width. Your change in width is 5.991, original width is 6. So from this I will get the value of lateral strain, which comes out to be, now we have to be careful here. First of all, this change in width, it is given in the problem that it is 5.991, that is the changed width, and if we want to calculate the how much is the change in width, here this indicates the new width, which I'll denote it as delta B1, and this will be delta T1. Now delta B, this will be 6 minus this value, because the original width was 6 and now it has changed. So this value comes out to be 9 into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by 6, and from this lateral strain comes out to be 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 4. Similarly, lateral strain can even be calculated as, I can write down also, lateral strain can even be written as change in thickness upon original thickness, and therefore lateral strain becomes, change in thickness is, original thickness was 6 and finally it has changed to 5.991 divided by, original thickness was 6, so lateral strain will be same, 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 4. Now after getting the value of lateral strain, the next thing we want is linear strain. So after getting this, I'll say that in linear strain, before that I'll write down Poisson's ratio, since, and see what do we get from here, since Poisson's ratio is given by, the formula is mu is equal to lateral strain upon linear strain. Now if we look into this problem, here they have not given us how much is the change in length, they have just given the change in width and thickness. The change in length is not known to us, so we cannot calculate strain by using change in length upon original length formula. So now here I have written that Poisson's ratio is lateral strain upon linear strain. Linear strain we can calculate it by using a concept, and that concept is, since we know that from Hooke's law, Young's modulus is equal to stress upon strain, so therefore strain is equal to stress upon Young's modulus. I am going to use this formula, and why I am using this formula, because in this case we don't have the value of delta L, which is the change in length. We have change in width and change in thickness, but change in length is not there. So here what I'll do, therefore mu is equal to lateral strain upon, in linear strain it is stress upon Young's modulus. So next, this value will get multiplied on the left hand side, so therefore mu into stress upon Young's modulus is equal to lateral strain. Now therefore, since we want to calculate mu, I'll keep mu on one side, linear strain, this capital E would be multiplied divided by stress. Lateral strain we have calculated, its value was 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 4. Young's modulus value we don't have, stress was 100, so therefore mu becomes 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 6 Young's modulus. I'll keep this as equation number, this would be equation 1 for us. Now after getting this equation, mu and capital E, that is Young's modulus, both are unknown values. We cannot get them by using this single equation. So there is some hint given in the problem, and that hint is in the form of G, which is called as modulus of rigidity. So we can use some relation in which we get modulus of rigidity and modulus of elasticity. So here I'll say that from this, now since the relation between modulus of elasticity and modulus of rigidity is given by, the formula is capital E is equal to 2g 1 plus mu. Now in this, capital E, I'll keep it as it is, 2 into g, the value of g is given, so it is 2 into 0.8 into 10 raised to 5, 1 plus mu is 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 6 into capital E. Now I'll multiply this value, so therefore capital E becomes, this is 160 into 10 raised to 3, and if I multiply it inside the bracket, here I have this value, so I'm opening the bracket, plus 160 into 10 raised to 3 multiplied by this term, which is 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 6, I'll get the answer as 0.24 capital E. Now since we want to calculate capital E, I would be shifting this term 0.24e onto the left hand side. So here I have capital E minus 0.24 capital E is equal to 160 into 10 raised to 3. So therefore this becomes 0.76 capital E is equal to 160 into 10 raised to 3. So finally capital E is equal to 160 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 0.76, and hence my answer of Young's modulus, that comes out to be 210.53 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square. So this will be answer number 1 for us. Now after getting this answer, we even want to calculate mu here, so I'll put this value of capital E in equation number 1. So therefore put capital E is equal to 210.53 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square in equation number 1. So here I have mu is equal to 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 6 into 210.53 into 10 raised to 3. So this, if I multiply all terms here, I am getting my answer of mu as 0.315, the second answer. So here if we look into the problem, they were asking us two questions, value of Poisson's ratio and Young's modulus. Poisson's ratio we have found out, it is 0.315, and Young's modulus is 210.53 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square. And after getting these two values, we can say that the problem is completed.